الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. Some observations with some of the dawah organizations that we have in the West, and of course they follow the pattern of some of the groups like Ikhwan al-Muslimin and some of the other organizations throughout the Muslim world in their minhaj or methodology in giving dawah to Allah. Because dawah, we have to remember, is a type of ibadah. It's a type of a way in which we come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a way and a means. It is worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a type of worship. Calling to who? Calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not calling to our group, not calling to our sect, not calling to our firqa, not calling to anything other than that. And in a very beautiful statement, Shaykhana Muqbil bin Hadi al-Wadi'i, Allah yarhamuhu, he said, when referring to the da'wah of da'wah to Ahl Sunnah, he said, da'wah to Ahl Sunnah, hiya da'wah to ila kitabillah min kitabillah wa ila sunnati rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ila sunnati rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said that da'wah, the da'wah of Ahl Sunnah, the call to Ahl Sunnah, the way in which Ahl Sunnah propagates Islam, is that they call from the Book of Allah, meaning the Quran, to the Quran, and they call from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning they don't call to themselves, they don't call to their group, they don't call to their conference, they don't call to their what have you, but rather they call to Kitabillah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the real fiqh fi deen and the tatbiq and practicing the deen. That's the understanding of the religion. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man yuridullahu bihi khayran yafaqahu fi deen." Whenever Allah wants good for a person, He gives him understanding of the religion. That's what we want. We want understanding of the religion, and we want to propagate that understanding of the religion. The understanding based on Kitabillah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this comes to the point of this short speech, if you will, and it is as advice to our brothers. For example, our brothers in the Al-Maghribi Institute and some of these other institutes that seem to encourage and entice the youth with entertainment dawah, by entertainment. And I've seen it. They have a conference called Elm Fest or something similar to this. So the Elm Festival, babe, this is beautiful. But where is the Elm when you're playing football and doing push-ups and doing some sort of dances to Anashid, and this is calling to Allah? Have we seen this from the ulama before us and even the later generations? Where does this come from? How does this dawah call to Kitabillah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam? So I question my brothers in this, and I ask that Allah guides us in them to the right path, and that they come back to Kitabillah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the madhab of the Salaf of this ummah. If you really want success, then it's by following Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not through entertainment. Naam, we know our youth is astray. We know we have a different society. We know we have different cultures we're dealing with. People who are non-Arab, people who are non-this and non-that and who are new to Islam. This is beautiful. But that doesn't mean we need to throw away and push aside the principles of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Because what kind of Muslims are you strengthening? What kind of deen are you building by calling to the Muslims to this type of entertainment dawah? It's just jokes and magic tricks and this and that and the other, pulling rabbits out of the hat. What is the natija? What is the end result? Are you making students of knowledge? Are you encouraging people to go study Kitabillah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Are you building communities by having these expensive conferences around the world and entertaining the people in various countries? This is what we have to question, and I question my brothers, and I'd love to hear an answer from them to see what they have to offer us as a Muslim community, the Muslim communities that are paying lots of money for these conferences. But in fact, we don't see that the ulama build their dawah based on conferences, based on expensive lectures, but rather they call the people and they teach the community. They stay put in the community. That doesn't mean not going on conferences. But let's get back to the crux of the matter. What is the dawah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What should we be calling to? قال سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم كل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said في كتابه الكريم to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم should say, he said, say, this is my path and call to Allah with basira. Basira is what? It's fiqh, it's understanding of the religion. It's practicing and it's understanding the religion based on Kitabillah wa Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, following the madhab of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That truly is a success. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnata khulafa rashidin al-mahdiin. Is upon you my sunnah. This is the medicine for us, for all of our sicknesses and the ills in the ummah. The fact that our brothers and sisters are being slaughtered in Syria. The fact that our brothers and sisters are being oppressed and slaughtered in Burma. The fact that our brothers and sisters are having their rights taken away in Sri Lanka, and the issues that we face in America, the oppression that we face, and the Islamophobia, and all throughout the West. What is the alaj? What is the medicine? Is it more jokes? Is it more stage performances? Is it more anashit? Or is it returning to Kitabillah wa Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Alaykum bi sunnati, it's upon you my sunnah. وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين and the rightly guided خليفي meaning أبو بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. That's the سبيل النجاة. That's the سبيل of success. That's the path of success. And then it came in the hadith of Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لما بعث معاذ اليمن قال إنك تأتي قوم من أهل الكتاب فليكن أول ما تدعوهم إليه شهرا لا إله إلا الله. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Mu'adh bin Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, when he sent him to Yemen, he said, verily you're going to a people from the people of the book, Ahl Kitab, meaning the Christians and the Jews. So make sure that the first thing you call them to is the Shahada. Is to shahadata in la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, calling to, bearing witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, and that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last prophet and messenger alayhi salatu wa salam. That's the call. That is the call. That doesn't mean that everything is not in its rightful place. That if you're having a camping outing or a camping trip, of course, entertain the youth. Enjoy doing things that are within the Sharia. That doesn't mean Ahl Sunnah doesn't laugh. Ahl Sunnah doesn't enjoy. We enjoy the mubah. We enjoy the halal. Those things that are permissible for us. But as far as changing the dawah, changing the dawah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with magic tricks of all things, with all these other side antics and things that we see in the circus. We see these in the circus. We view and we expect to see these things in David Copperfield's performances, but we don't expect to see this to people who are calling to Kitabillah wa Sunnatu Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people yantasibul al-ilm, those people who consider themselves from people of knowledge, and the people look up to them. Those people, most of those brothers are graduates of a very esteemed university, Jamia Islamia. They've come and Allah's favored them with that. So they have a responsibility to call people to Kitabillah wa Sunnatu Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and leave off those doubtful things. Leave off those things which just become another way of entertainment. Like the people who make debates thinking they're calling to Allah. They want to debate the Christians. That their whole dawah is based upon that. Was that the dawah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you get many Muslims who come to Islam from that kind of dawah? Do you build communities from that kind of dawah? Do you have people who really tamassuk bi Kitab wa Sunnah, or do they stay on the same ma'asi and they get entertained by those videotapes? That's the question I have, and that's what I've seen in my experience, and many of us have observed that, and you put that to the test. always ask yourself, brothers and sisters, whenever you're listening to someone, are they calling to themselves? Are they calling to their group? Are they calling to Kitabillah or Sunnah Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the Salaf of this Ummah, their madhab, their methodology? And if the question is yes on the last question, then those are the ones you want to take knowledge from and you want to be safe with. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept this good and forgive this evil, anything I said that was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. And may Allah guide us and all of those who are calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to correct ourselves, to correct our aqidah, to correct our methodology in calling to Allah. Those people who are successful Sufis, may Allah call them back to the sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to leave Hizbiyah, to leave calling into group and partisanship, to leave going and being Ashari and being Sufi and being Takfiri and being of this group, being with Ikhwan al-Muslimin and these other groups and sects. May Allah protect us from that and may Allah give us guidance. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.